Okay, so is it visible? Okay, before going to the problem, I'll just give a glance to you guys. Just go through it once, because without that you cannot solve any of the problem. So first thing is faults. So yesterday class I told you how you can judge the fault current, because every time you cannot remember what is the formula for finding the fault current. So you have a tricks that LL fault, LG fault, LLG fault, with, without, how to determine IF. So we know that fault current which are existing through ground, that is LG, LLG. In that case, your fault current equation will be IF is equals to 3 times of IA0, that is magnitude of IA0. Similarly, fault without grounding means just a line to line ground. In that case, your question means your formula for determining the fault current is root 3 times of magnitude of IA1. Okay, so with respect to that, we had a number of cases. Is it? So hope you can see symmetrical components relationship, the basic one. So then we start up with LL fault, LLG fault, LG fault, is it? So this is the basic diagram we are writing for every cases, representing with where is the fault. Fault is existing at one phase, fault is existing at two phases, means two lines. So that you are considering and determining each phase. So that's the line to line fault, is it? So what is the symmetrical diagram? So considering that, you got some of the terminal voltages, terminal concept of current and voltage, considering that you are writing the diagram. So this diagram is specially for line to line fault without any fault impedance. This sequential diagram is very necessary for us to solve the problem. LL fault, you have a positive negative at one port, and IA0 or VA0 is equal to zero, that is a zero sequence at the another part. So considering these two sequential diagrams, you guys are going to determine the fault current, that is for LL fault. Similarly, and more easy, LL fault, as I said, your fault current formula will be magnitude of IF is equal to root 3 times of IA1, or as you can write it as IF is equal to root 3 times of magnitude of IA1, means if it is plus or minus, it will not bother the system. Okay, similarly, LLG, so it is 3 into IA0. I already told you, LLG, LG faults, if it is there, G, ground, with the ground, if it is existing, your equation will be 3 into IA0. So let's see for LLG fault, what is the sequential diagram? So terminal voltages, already it is done. So this is the sequential diagram for LLG fault. Means you have a positive sequence, negative sequence, and zero sequence, all are connected in parallel format, is it? So IA1, IA2, IA0. Considering this, you have to solve. So finally, what is the agenda? I need to find out the fault current. You see here, the fault current is 3 into IA1. So you can write IF is equals to 3A0 or IF is equals to 3A1. You can see IF is equals to 3A0. So this is LL and LG fault. Similarly, with fault impedance, with fault impedance, what is the sequence diagram? So common sequential diagram, but ZF will be added. This parameter, whatever is existing, see, this is line to ground, right? So this is ZF is added at the first line, IA. So what is the effect? So that will be written in the sequential diagram. So sequential network, as usual, it was continuous series network, you're getting it. This ZF, which is included with all the series, that's what you're written, 3ZF. So this sequential diagram for LG fault. Then you are going to find out what is IA0, what is IA1, IA2, and VA1, VA2, VA3. Because see, if it is series connected, we know that the current is constant. So if you calculate any one, there is no need to find out for IA2, IA0. You are equating all are same. IA0 is equal to IA1 is equal to IA2. But I need to determine the voltage drops at each terminal. So V1, V2, V0. So hope you can see that VA1, VA2, VA0, and you are applying the KVL and you are taking the equation. Fine. So what is the final formula for finding the fault current? So this is LG. LG, if it is exist, that is 3 into IA 0, because LG, LLG with fault, without fault, there is no difference. The formula will be IF is equal to 3 times of IA 0, because your current is constant, series connection. So current will not change. You can write IA 1, IA 2, IA 0, no problem. So that is common values. Similarly, LL, LL fault with fault impedance. With fault impedance, how will be your diagram? So already we have a basic diagram for the last case. So two separate sequences, two separately they are existing for positive, negative, and as well as for the zero sequence. So here there is the existence of, because these two lines, IA and IB, IB and IC, IB and IC are connected through this fault impedance ZF. So this effect is not there on the zero sequence. So ZF exists in first diagram, and zero sequence is not having anything except Z0. There is 3 ZN plus ZG0. So as usual, find out all the values, because two separate quantity we have. So you can take any one current, because series network, one current path, you can take it I1 or I2. So I'll consider IA1, because IA2 is same, but opposite in direction, you are writing IA1 is equal to minus IA2. But it is very, very much necessary for me to determine another current flowing in this path also, because this is separate block. So as we calculated already in the basic condition, your IA0 is equal to VA0, that is 0 itself. Then find out voltages at each point, VA1, VA2, VA0. So finally, what do we want? I want IF. So IF is equals to, this is LL fault. LL fault with impedance, without impedance, your answer will be the same. That is IF is equals to root 3 times of IA1, that is magnitude of IA1. So these are the basic diagrams. Okay. So because in the problem, they will give one content and they will ask you to find out. So LLG also same thing. You have to write the sequential diagram including ZF. So including ZF means what you will get? See here, ZF is added here. And again, remaining calculations, you do it. Finally, I want IF. So this is LLG. Again, G is existing means your answer will be in terms of 3 IA 0 or 3 IA 1. Okay. So this is the basic stuff for faults with impedance, without impedance. So considering this parameter, we guys are moving ahead to calculate the problems. Please note this points, these two points, because see, instead of remembering the various results for a particular fault, it is often easier to visualize the connection of sequence network. Means just by seeing the look sequence diagram, you can justify, is it of LL fault, LLG fault, LG fault, and if you come to know which fault it is, then it is easy to take up the standard formula directly. No need to go for analysis. So if you forgot to do that, then from the beginning you have to start initializing yourself to find out terminal values, then finding the symmetrical components, then applying it, finding the final answer. So that's what it is, a minimum hint given to the students to remember. For LG and LLG fault, your answer will be IF is equal to 3 times of magnitude of IA0, and similarly for line to line fault, your value is IF is equals to root 3 times of IA1. So with this basic knowledge, we guys are moving ahead to solve the problem. Please note down the first question. Take down a three-phase generator with an open circuit voltage of open circuit voltage of 400 volt, copy down this, 400 volt is adjusted or is subjected, but is subjected to an LG fault. LG fault through a fault impedance of J2 ohm. First off, determine the fault current fault current, if Z1 is equals to J4 ohm, Z2 is equals to J2 ohm, and Z0 is equals to J1 ohm. Means all our complex terms they are given, 4 ohms, 2 ohms, 1 ohm. Then what you just see, repeat the problem for LL and LLG fault. So with the same condition, you are going to repeat the problem for the another two cases, LL and LLG. So first condition, we will take up with the problem which is given in terms of LG. Write down LG fault. Here just values are given. Basic thing for you guys is to write down the sequential diagram. Okay, so first for LLG fault. LG faults are not LLG, it is LG fault. So this is the sequence diagram. So all series, so they are not specified. So yeah, this question is included with through a fault impedance. So fault impedance has been included here. You can see ZF is equals to J6 ohm. And all the values are entered here. That is 4, 2 and 1 ohm. So next, we need to start calculating because finally I need to answer for IF. And hope you guys have observed, they're given the value called 400. They're given 400. But here, what is the voltage source? Voltage source is existing at only one phase. I need to find out phase voltage. So VL is equals to what? Root 3 times of phase voltage. Is it correct? So this is common formula of your three-phase system. But what I want each phase, how much is the value? So here, this is the value is VL. Each line value they have given. So VL is equal to 400. But each phase I need to find out, that is VP is equals to VL by root 3. So that is 400 by root 3 at an angle of 0 degree. Fine. So I got, you can write VP or EP, no problem for me. So anything can be accepted. But to have a clarity, because sources we are representing as E and terminal voltages we are representing in terms of V. So make difference. E will act as a sources and V will act as a terminal voltage across each phases. Fine. Then in the series connection, as we already know that what is constant, your current will be constant. So I'll write IA1 is equals to IA2 is equals to IA0. Means any one, if you write, that is applicable to all the cases. What is that I, V by R? So from whole circuit, you can see I have only one source, that is EA or EA1. So you can write that as EA itself divided by what? All the impedances. Series connections means what? They're connected back to back. So I'm going to add each and every resistance. Z1 plus Z2 plus Z0 plus 3ZF. So we'll write the summation of all the impedances. Z1 plus Z2 plus what is that? Z0, and the last one is, it is 0, and the last one is 3ZF. So next you have to do the calculation and give me the answer. In the place of EA, substitute this value 400 divided by root 3 at an angle of 0, and in the place of Z1, Z2, Z3, count, take Z outside, so count it, 4 plus 2, 6, 6 plus 1, 7, 7 plus 6, how much it is? 13. So J13, you're going to get it. So convert this, divide this first, convert this to the rectangular form, and please give me what is the answer you guys are getting it. Can you do this? 400 divided by root 3 at an angle of 0. First divide this, convert the polar to rectangular. Denominator, I have all the summation. So this is 3ZF, complete 3ZF itself, 6. No need to multiply 6 into 3 again. The whole 3ZF value is 6. 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 plus 4, it is 13, I'll write. So please do the simplification and give me what is the answer. Is it audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Rashmi. See, guys have not said I have shared the screen. I was just writing over there. I don't know what you're observing. Simply people are keeping quiet means what to do? Have you taken the problem?
No, Kishore, your problem. I don't know.
No. I'm writing. I've started solving here. Okay. Write down and find the answer. What is the answer? Simplify and tell me what is the answer, Sharad?
Sharad is not here.
Then who are on there? Geetesh is there? Yeah, Geetesh, Subramani and Rashmi. Yeah. First, you write down the sequential diagram for LG fault and try to remember all this. LG will be in a series connection. And here in the problem, they specified it's through fault through impedance. That's what ZF is included. Okay. Then they are given the line voltage. But I want each phase. That's what you written the formula. If V is equals to VL by root 3 at an angle of 0. Then series connection current is constant. So you can write anyone is equals to V by R. What is R? All the impedances are connected in series. Z1 plus Z2 plus Z0 plus 3ZF. Please do the simplification and tell me what is the answer you are getting, guys. If you understand this concept, it is simple to solve many questions. But only the agenda is you need to remember the sequential diagram for each cases. And I can expect this problems in final exam as well as in the internals. Fine. Can I get the answer? Solve it fast. What is the answer, Subramani?
Solving.
Yeah, do it fast. Because you need to do another two cases also. You have to solve for LL and as well as LLG fault for the same question. Yes, Geetesh, what is the answer?
Now also the screen is not sharing, man.
No, I have not shared. That's what.
Yes.
Go on that. Now solve this and give me the answer. Finished? Can you tell me what is the answer? Yes, Rashmi, how much time you want to solve the simple one? What is the answer, Rashmi? Geetesh? If we don't answer, then the only question will be retained same. Solve it fast. Any answers? Can I get it from your side? So if you solve this, you're going to get minus J 17.765. Is it correct? 17.765 amps. But this is just with the phase. That is, IA1 is equal to IA2 is equal to IA0. But what you want to calculate? You want to calculate fault. So in that case, your answer will be IF is equal to 3 times of the magnitude of IA0. So guys, has to multiply this 17.765 into 3. So when you multiply that with 3, you're going to get an answer called 53.295 amps. 295 amps. Yes, Rashmi?
53.8.
Okay, your answer is correct. It's matching with it.
Yes, ma'am.
Very good. Okay, so as for that, we have solved only one case, that is LG fault. Next, we want to go for LG fault. So when you go for solving it, what we want? We want a sequential diagram. Without sequential diagram, you cannot do, right? So first, we'll write the sequential diagram for the system. Do you remember for LG fault? See, for LG fault, always two different segments. One is with positive and negative sequence. Another one is for zero sequence. So this is with respect to A0. And this is with respect to A1 and A2. Okay, so I'll just copy the diagram. So you can go for this. See, I think you can verify the answer, 53.295. So LLG fault. So I'll take this. So first you copy down this diagram and write the heading LL fault. LL fault. So LL fault, positive negative at one port and another one at the last port. So you know that A1, Z1, ZF and Z2, and here it is Z0. Okay. So substitute all the values same, 4, 2, 2 and 1. So first read the question once again before going for it. A three-phase generator with an open circuit voltage of 500 subjected to an LG even fault impedance, right? 2. It is just 2. But if it is connected in 3 series, you'll have a 3 times, so you're multiplied 3 into 2, it has become 6. But now it is connected between the system, so you're writing it as 2 itself, ZF. And determine your fault current, Z1, Z2, Z0, 2, 4, 2, and 1. So 4, 2, and 1. So nothing else. So remaining L and LLG fault. So once this is done, so hope you'll understand, I need to determine two different parameters. One is the current flowing in the circuit, another one is current flowing in the second circuit. So one more thing, observation, if I consider the impedance, fault impedance, you just see the direction of current flowing. So one, both are moving towards, but when you compare with the first, then it will against the system. So you're going to write IA1 is equal to minus IA2. So let's we go for a first case, IA1 calculation. Current flowing through in the first network. So that is V, because voltage source I have only one. So EA divided by, again, resistances are connected in series. Z1, Z2, ZF. So Z1 plus Z2 plus ZF. So what is that EA? As usual, 400. If you converted already, keep the same answer here. 400 divided by root 3 into 0 degree divided by, you do the summation of these three, 4 plus 2, 6, 6 plus 2, 8. So J, 8. Can you please simplify and give me the answer? What is the answer for this? What is J8? Like J, and above form also you make it in rectangular. SME minus minus 28.87 amps. So we got the basic one, what is required. But I want to calculate the fault current to LL fault. So LL fault means what is the standard formula we have? IF is equals to root 3 times of magnitude of IA1. So can you do this 28.87? So that is magnitude means no, neglect that minus sign. So just you take 28.87 into root. You multiply and tell me what is the answer. Yes, Subramani.
So
49.92. Can I make it 50? Because it is 49.9, I can write it as a 50 amps as a fault current going through LL fault. So everyone done this? And we are left with the last case, LLG fault. LLG fault. If you want to solve that LLG fault, what I want for sequential diagram. So shall I rub this? Okay, so we'll go to the last case of LLG fault. So LLG fault, what is the sequence network? It is again, it is a series combination where you have a 3ZF existence. Sorry, not a series, it is a parallel combination, phase 1, phase 2, and phase 0. So I'll copy this. So based on that, we'll write the equation. So first we write the sequence diagram including your ZF condition. So first A, any of positive sequence, negative sequence where the sources are shorted, and the third case where these two in between B and this, we have a ZF, the impedance, 3ZF. 3ZF, ZF is 2. So 3ZF means it will become 6 ohm. So now we have to understand the concept of voltage divider rule. Already we discussed. If you want to calculate the current flowing through IA2, then total current flowing through, this is series combination we are considering, and these two are in a parallel network. So IA1 is acting as a total current, and here this is the opposite resistance for IA2, that is Z0. Similarly for IA0, opposite resistance is Z2. Sum of these two will act as a Z0 plus Z2. Okay, keeping this in mind, we'll start with the first calculation. IA1 means I need to find out the complete current flowing through the network. So this is IA1 is a total current. So total current means I need to consider this circuit also as well as this circuit also. So we'll take the first case. IA1 is equals to, anyhow, there is no disturbance with respect to sources. You can write directly EA, but denominator is very, very important. So here you can see, this is in series with the source Z1, of course. Z1 is in series, but these two are in parallel combination. Means you have to write R1 R2 divided by R1 plus R2. But before that, again, you can observe these two are in series. Z0 plus 3ZF are in series. So you can simplify this and then you can write it, or else you can write directly as I write here. So take the big bracket Z2 in. So these two are in series, just add it, Z0 plus 3ZF. Z0 plus 3ZF into R1 plus R2, right? So just add all the terms, that is Z2, Z0 plus ZF. Okay, so close the bracket here. So EA, anyhow, same answer, it is 400. Divided by root 3. I don't know what is the rectangular form answer. So please do that. 400 rectangle of root 3 divided by. So Z2. So please do the simple mathematical calculation here. So one is 4 ohm plus, what is that? 2 into 6 divided by 2 plus 9. So totally 9 it is. So 9. So please simplify this and tell me what is the answer you are getting it. Subramani, I want answer from your side also. Gitesh, it's not that only Rashmi should answer for all the questions. Answer it.
ma'am.
How much, pa?
40.328.
40 or 41? Just see to it once. Because I got 41 here.
Ma'am, even I got 43.328, ma'am.
43 or 40? You are saying 40.
43.
Subramani, how much you are getting?
43, ma'am.
See, this is 2. I think I did a mistake here. 2. 6 plus 1 you have to write, right? It is 7. 2 into 7 you do. Sorry, 2 into 1. 7 it is. Just do it because here it is ZF plus Z naught. ZF, sorry, Z naught is 1, 3 ZF is 6, 6 plus 1 is 7, 2 7, 2 7 is 14 divided by 9. Now you make it, you will see. Any changes in answer? Gita?
No, I got 44.22, ma'am.
44? Just check out to see the Subramani. Okay, then you multiply. Take down one more also. Find for IA 0. You'll see, I will also verify once.
And
41.53 is correct. That's what. Okay, just write the same. 41.57 minus J. 41.57 amps. Okay, this is for IA 1, but I need to find out IA 0 also, because here again this is a parallel loop is existing, right? So we need to find out IA 0. So IA 0, if for calculating this, you can go for dividing rule. IA 0 is equals to total current flowing through the network, that is IA 1, into opposite resistance. So IA 0 is here, right? Which is the opposite resistance existing here? Z2. So Z2 divided by sum of all the resistances. Z2 plus Z0 plus 3ZF. Z2 plus Z0 plus 3ZF. Can you please simplify these values? Already you got IA1 answer. That's what we calculated IA1 here. IA1 if you know, then we can calculate IA0. Because your formula for calculating a fault current is IF is equals to 3 times of magnitude of IA0. Because of that reason itself, we are calculating. So calculate this. IA1 is 41 you take. Z2, any of it is 2. 2 plus 6 plus 1. How much it is telling me? Rashmi, I think you need to check out your calculation because I also got the same answer. It is 41.56 for me. You just check out for this IA1. Okay. So can you tell me what is the answer for this IA0? IA0 is equals to? Any answer, Subramani? Can you tell me what is the answer? Are you there? Yes, give the answer faster. IA0 is how much? 2 divided by 9 into 41.57. How much you'll get? You'll get 9.24. J 9.24. So 9.24 into 3. How much you'll get? You'll get an answer called 27.72 amps. So this is the way how you have to solve the faults in the system. LL, LG and LLG fault. Through fault impedance. So you have to be very careful. That is through fault impedance. So hope you got this answer. Everyone done with this problem? Okay, if so, we'll move on to the another problem, guys. Take on the next question. So if you want, you can verify the answers here. Okay. So take on the question. I'll just read out the question here. You solve this and get back. Okay. A three-phase generator. With line to line voltage is 400 volt subjected to an LLG fault. First off, if Z1 is J2 ohm, Z2 is 0.5 ohm, 0.5 ohm, and Z0 is 0.25 ohm, 0.25 ohm. Determine the fault current and terminal voltages. First read the question, because they are asking to find out the fault current using LLG. There is no other cases like LL or LG. So LLG they are directly asking, and at the same time you understand that there is no fault impedance. Just there are first Z1, Z2, and means positive, negative and zero sequence, except that nothing else is existing. So you need to find out fault current, that is the basic stuff. Then you have to find out the terminal values. So terminal values in the sense IA1, IA2, IA0 means each individually you have to determine the system. Okay, so we're going to have a same diagram for, because it is a LLG fault, right? Last problem we solved on LLG, so this is LLG fault itself, but you're not going to have this 3ZF because we don't have any fault impedance. Okay, so change the values. So this is 2 ohm and here it is 0.5 ohm, and the last case is 0.25 ohm. So please change that values, 0.25 ohm. So find out for each and every, because this is a parallel network, means you have to determine each and individually current IA1, IA2, IA0. So last case we discussed only one, IA1 and IA0, but here you need to find out IA2 also. So IA2 means this is the IA2, total current IA1, opposite resistance is Z0, Z0 divided by Z2 plus Z0. So I will give you all the formulas here. So you guys solve that and give me what is the answer. So anyhow, this formula is same as it is, I'll leave, but ZF is not existing. So remove this ZF. Okay. So first case IA1. So anyhow, you need to find out EA. Already this is existing, same value 400. You can write directly EA is equals to 400 divided by root 3. So you're going to get an answer called 230.9 in rectangular form plus J0. Okay, IA1 is what? EA divided by all the values, you have to write it here. So EA divided by, same as last problem, you have Z1 plus Z2 Z0 divided by Z2 plus Z0. So this is first formula for calculating IA1. Okay, then IA2, I'll just take this. This is minus IA1. IA2 is existing. So IA1 is over. IA2 we need to find out. IA2 is this. What is the opposite resistance? Z0. Write it as Z0 divided by Z0 plus Z2. Fine. Next, this is IA2, not right. Okay, then the last one is IA0. IA0 opposite resistance is Z2, that is total resistance, total current you write it as IA1, that is opposite direction, right, minus IA1 divided by Z2 divided by Z1 plus Z2. So simplify all this, find out what is IA1, IA2, IA0, then I need to find out IF. So IF, we know that what is the standard formula for this, that is 3 into magnitude of IA0. Okay, so first you tell me what is the answer for each case, then substitute it here, you're going to get the final fault current under LLG system. Is it okay? If you have any doubts regarding this, you can ask me. Here, as I say, main thing, you need to be aware of the sequence diagrams. If you messed up writing a sequence diagram, then your complete answers will go wrong from the step one, not from step two or step three. Step one itself, you'll fail to get the proper answer. Then remaining will continue in the same pattern. That's what. Practice the derivations 2 to 3 times. Derivations will also come. If the derivation is not existing, problem will be definitely there in the calculation part. If you have any doubts, you can ask me. If not, we can wind up the class. So next class also we'll get one or two problems. Then we move ahead with the another concepts. Fine. And as I messaged you guys, control system observation should be written and submitted. Now I am posting that all the experiments whichever is done, root locus, Bode plot, and Simulink execution of time response and DC control, PLC controller, all the 5 experiments, not 5, 6, totally 6, should be written in your observation. That should be uploaded, because I was expecting you guys to be executed and submit the answers, but not even a single response I have received yet. So because of that reason, we'll follow the same old pattern of writing an observation, go through the observation, solve it, and submit. Copy the observation as usual. For root locus and all, minimum one problem should be solved theoretically, and that should be uploaded. Clear? I'll give you a good time itself, 4 to 5 days. Finish it, because this is intimated already 2 days before. So you will get still more time within Monday. Next Monday, you have to be submit the observation. Is it fine? And I think I have returned all the marks, internal marks. If you are eligible, you will get it. If not, it is only with third position. Hope everyone is having eligibility. So I shared the marks. If you have any doubts, you can ask me. I think this time the response was good enough. Solar and wind energy, somewhere people are lagged and they're not attempted the problem, particularly Subbu. You're not taken up the problem at all. Because of that self, your marks have been reduced. Okay. So study well and give your best in your internals to get out of hope. If you have any doubts, you can ask me, or else we'll wind up the class now.
No, ma'am.
Okay. You can leave.